Hello students, good morning. Today we will start a new chapter, Chemical Kinetics. I hope you remember about thermodynamics that you have studied last year. At least the delta G and corona test are the only things that we expect to be negative. If delta G equal to negative, then that reaction will take place. Then that reaction will be spontaneous. We will say that everything we should begin in a positive attitude. We should have a positive outlook for everything. But in chemistry, for a reaction to take place, for a reaction to be spontaneous, the delta G should be negative. So being negative is not that much bad, at least in this situation. So thermodynamics says a reaction will be possible if delta G equal to negative. Then comes equilibrium in our story. At least you should remember equilibrium constant K. The value of K determines what kind of reaction it is. If value of K is large, that means you will get a lot of products. If value of K is less, the reaction will easily attain equilibrium. Then most of the reactant will remain unreacted as such. So the extent of a reaction is determined by equilibrium. Even though whether a reaction is feasible or not is determined by thermodynamics. So these are two important things, feasibility and extent. Feasibility means whether that will take place or not. That is determined by thermodynamics. Delta G should be negative. And okay, fine, it will take place spontaneously. Then comes the second question. To what extent this will proceed? No reaction will continue indefinitely. At a particular stage, it will attain equilibrium. When it will attain equilibrium? That is determined by K, equilibrium constant. So the story is still incomplete. In order to complete that story, we need one more character, a most important character, chemical kinetics, that discuss about the rate of a chemical reaction. At what rate the reaction will proceed? This is determined by chemical kinetics. I will explain by comparing it with a situation in real life. Suppose tomorrow is your exam. First problem is feasibility, whether you will study or not. Feasibility. Second, extent. Okay, fine, you have determined to study. How many chapters you will complete before going to sleep? How many chapters you will complete? That is extent. How long you will go? And third one, last but not the least, rate is important. At what speed you are studying? Some students is having a habit of studying fast. Some students are slow in studying. So these three are very important. Feasibility, whether it will take place or not, determined by thermodynamics. Extent to which the reaction will proceed before attain equilibrium, it is determined by equilibrium constant. Third one, chemical kinetics. It is all about rate of a chemical reaction. Yes, let's define chemical kinetics. It is the branch of chemistry that deals with the study of rate of a chemical reaction and factors affecting the rate. Once again, chemical kinetics is the branch of chemistry that deals with the study of rate of a chemical reaction and factors affecting the rate. You can pause the video and write down that definition. With that definition, you can start writing your notes. First definition in this chapter, what is chemical kinetics? Of course, it will not be asked in the exam as such, but you should have an idea what it is. It is a branch of chemistry that deals with the study of rate and factors affecting the rate. Okay, moving on. Next question is, what is the purpose of studying rate? Yes, there is a purpose. Definitely there is a purpose. Once you are aware about the rate of a reaction, you will think about what are the factors affecting the rate. then you will start thinking about what all things will help you to increase the speed. Okay, that is our purpose, to increase the speed. We need to get things done in a faster manner. So, optimize reaction condition. So, adjusting temperature, adjusting pressure, catalyst or surface area, whatever be the factor, we can increase the rate of a chemical reaction. So, that is the purpose of studying chemical kinetics. Okay, we cannot study anything without understanding the purpose. So, study the purpose first. What is this used for? This will help us to optimize the reaction condition so as to get maximum yield. This branch of chemistry will teach you how to optimize the reaction condition so as to get maximum yield. Okay? So, we have studied two things. First of all, the definition of chemical kinetics. What chemical kinetics is? Second one, why or what is the purpose of studying chemical kinetics? The purpose is very simple. It helps us to optimize the reaction condition in order to get maximum yield. Yes, fine. Now, we need to talk something about rate. In physics, the word we use more is speed. Speed equal to distance by time. This is a very basic equation in physics. Speed equal to distance by time. Unit of distance is meter, time is second. So, unit of speed in physics is meter per second. Here, in the case of chemical reaction, speed is not in the unit of meter per second. It's obvious. We cannot measure the rate of a chemical reaction in meter per second. Rate of a chemical reaction is the change in concentration divided by time. Not distance by time, but it is change in concentration divided by time. Change in concentration of either the reactants or product. You can approach it in two ways. That is, you can analyze the speed by analyzing how much reactants have reacted or how much products have been formed. Both ways you can look the problem. So, rate of a chemical reaction is defined as change in concentration divided by time. Okay, so how will you define rate of a chemical reaction? It is the change in concentration of reactants or products per unit time. How will you define rate of a chemical reaction? Change in concentration of reactants or products. You can approach in two ways. In unit time. Okay, per unit time. So what will be its unit? Definitely it's not going to be meter per second. So what will be its unit? Its unit is, concentration unit is mol·L·1, mol per liter. Time means divided by second. So, second inverse. So, this is going to be the unit of rate, mol·L·1, second inverse. By now, we have studied three things. First of all, what is chemical kinetics? Second one, what is the purpose of studying chemical kinetics? Third one, what is rate? It is the change in concentration per unit time. So, of course, its unit will become mol·L·1, second·1. Shall we proceed? Next thing what I want to discuss is, suppose, at least in some construction sites, you might have seen how people, workers will mix cement, sand, metal, etc. to make concrete. Okay. So that rate of cement mixing. So I am discussing about that situation. In construction site, people will mix cement, sand, metal, water, etc. to make concrete. So there is rate of mixing equal to rate of disappearance of sand equal to rate of disappearance of cement or rate of disappearance of water. Will all these be same? Yes or no? Think for a while and then proceed. You are in a construction site. People are mixing cement, sand, water, metal, etc. to make concrete. So, of course, the speed of mixing, that is rate of mixing. Sand is used for that, water is used for that, metal is used for that. So, everyone is getting disappeared. Everything is getting consumed. Rate of mixing is not equal to rate of disappearance of sand. And that is not equal to rate of disappearance of cement. And that is exactly different from rate of disappearance of water, which will be entirely different from rate of disappearance of what? Metal. So all these will be different because all are used in different ratio. Cement and sand is not in the same ratio. So ratio matters. Ratio matters. In your house, for making tea, we need sugar and tea powder. Rate of consumption of sugar and rate of consumption of tea powder are both same? Never. Both are different. We need more sugar compared to tea powder. Am I right? So, rate of something depends on the ratio also. Rate of something depends on ratio also. Let's come back to chemistry. Then you will get a more clear idea. Because in chemistry, ratios are more important. Here, you consider a reaction 2A plus B giving 3C plus D. You consider a reaction 2A plus B giving 3C plus D. This is our reaction. 2A plus B giving 3C plus D. Here, we have an average rate of the reaction. And also, the rate of disappearance of A. A will be disappeared from the mixture because A is getting consumed. A is the reactant. Rate of disappearance of A. That will be different from rate of disappearance of B. That will be different from rate of formation of C. And that will be entirely different from rate of formation of D. One more thing I can say. Here there is no coefficient here. Or the coefficient is 1. There average rate will be equal to rate of formation of D. Here it will be same. Average rate and rate of formation of D will be same. Because there is nothing before D. There is no coefficient. Yes, there is a coefficient, that is 1. Since it is 1, rate of formation of D will be equal to average rate of the reaction. But rate of formation of C is not equal to average rate of the reaction. Rate of disappearance of A is not equal to average rate of the reaction. What about B? The coefficient of B is 1. So, rate of disappearance of B will be equal to average rate of the reaction. Okay? I will consider another reaction. P plus 2Q giving 3R plus 4S. This reaction will be having an average rate. Do you remember the unit of rate? Mole, liter raised to minus 1, second raised to minus 1. What was the definition for rate? Change in concentration of reactants or products in unit time. Yes. Consider this reaction P plus 2Q giving 3R plus 4S. It will be having an average rate. And that average rate will be equal to rate of disappearance of P. because coefficient of p is 1. Average rate will be equal to rate of disappearance of p because coefficient of p is 1. But rate of reaction is not equal to rate of disappearance of q. Average rate of the reaction not equal to rate of formation of r. Average rate of reaction not equal to rate of formation of s. Okay, because the coefficients are different. Now let's see how to write average reaction. How to write an expression for average rate. Before that, there is another term that I need to introduce you, that is instantaneous rate. Suppose you are moving in a bus having an average speed of 40 km per hour. Average speed of 40 km per hour. That doesn't mean that bus will always be in 40 km per hour. Sometimes bus will increase the speed. Sometimes bus will decrease the speed. Sometimes bus will be stopped in a traffic block or something. Okay, it will be different. At a particular instant, the speed will be different. During a dangerous curve, the bus will be moving very slowly. Okay, and if the road is very free, bus will be moving very fast. So at each instant the rate will be different, and that rate is called instantaneous rate. Just like at this position, moving from A to B, the bus will be having an average rate, average speed. In the case of bus, it is speed. The bus will be having an average speed. That will be different from the instantaneous speed here. At this position, bus will be having another instantaneous speed. At this position, bus was having instantaneous speed of 0. What does that mean? At this point, bus came to rest. Again, it started. Here, the instantaneous speed was maximum. Like that, it can be. So, average rate means the rate between a time period. Instantaneous rate means the rate at a particular instant. I hope you understood the difference between average rate and instantaneous rate. Okay? Fine. Now, let us see how to write the expression for average rate. It's very easy. Writing the expression for average rate is, let's consider this reaction, 2A plus B giving 3C plus D. I told you that we can find out the average rate by seeing the reactants or by seeing the product. We can find average rate by seeing the reactants or by seeing the products. But there is a difference. During a reaction, amount of reactants goes on decreasing and amount of products goes on increasing. So this will make a difference in the sign. Reactants, it is always decreasing. So whenever we are finding the average rate from reactants, we should use a negative sign, such that the total rate should be positive. Then only the total rate will become positive, because the amount of reactants is decreasing. Amount of reactants will be decreasing during the course of a reaction. So when you find out the average rate from the amount of reactants, you should use a negative sign. Let's see. Average rate equal to first of all, I am finding it out from A. A is a reactant, so I should use a negative sign. Then I need to consider the ratio. Here the coefficient is 2. So I should write 1 by 2. Then simple, change in concentration by time. Delta concentration of A by delta T. This is average rate obtained from the concentration of A. I can also obtain average rate from concentration of B. That will be equal to, again, B is a reactant, so I should use a negative sign. Then only the average rate will become positive. negative sign, and the coefficient is 1. So fine, nothing to be done. We can directly write change in concentration by time. This is how we will find out average rate. We need to consider whether it is reactant or product. If it is reactant, we should take a negative sign. And also we need to consider ratio. If there is a number like 2, then we need to use a fraction 1 by 2. If there is no number, then you are free. Directly you can write change in concentration by time. Then we can find average rate from C. Then we can write find average rate from C. How will you find average rate from C? It is a product. No need to use negative sign. Okay. You will directly get it positive. Okay. So no need to make it positive by adding a negative sign. It will be directly positive. So positive value. Then ratio you need to consider. Here there is 3. So I should use a fraction 1 by 3. 1 by 3. Then change in concentration by time. Delta concentration of C by delta T. One more way you can find out. I am writing here equal to, which is another way, from D, isn't it? And the sign will be negative or positive. Positive, D is a product, no problem. Positive sign you can use. Will there be any factor? Will there be any fraction? No, because coefficient is 1. Directly write delta concentration of D by delta T. This is what I said. Average rate and rate of disappearance of B, both are same. Average rate and rate of formation of D, both are same. But in the case of A and C, there is an extra fraction. In the case of A and C, there is an extra fraction. I thought you understood how to write the expression for average rate. And how will you make it as the expression for instantaneous rate? That is more easy. You just make delta into D. You just make delta into D. D concentration of A by dt. Now it will become instantaneous rate. You write it separately, okay? You make delta into D. Then it will become instantaneous rate. Delta V by delta T. dV by dt. It is instantaneous rate. You might have heard in physics also you are doing the same thing. What is velocity? D by dt of displacement. Like that. What is rate? D by dt of concentration. Rate is nothing but d by dt of concentration. Now, delta you should replace as d. D by dt of C, d by dt of B, d by dt of A. Here also. Then it will become the expression of instantaneous rate. So, writing expression is very easy. In the case of average rate, you should use delta. In the case of instantaneous rate, you should use D. Pause the video and write expression for instantaneous rate also. Okay, fine. Now moving on, let's study another reaction. One more example that you should do alone. Question is, 3P plus 2Q. 3P plus 2Q giving C plus half D. Okay, C plus half D. Or no need to take C plus half D, R plus half S, PQRS. You can take it like this. 3P plus 2Q giving R plus half S. So, pause the video for a second and write the expression for average rate and instantaneous rate. I will wait for you. Pause the video and write the expression for average rate and instantaneous rate. Yes, have you completed? I will help you. It's very simple. Here you can see, first I will write average rate equal to, average rate equal to, from P I should write first. First I should write from P, isn't it? From P I should write first. P is a reactant. P is a reactant. So I should use negative sign. Minus. P is a reactant. So I should use negative sign. Then there is a fraction. Here it is 3. So I should use minus 1 by 3. Delta concentration of P by
delta T.
Minus 1 by 3 delta concentration of P by delta T.
Equal to,
from Q, how will I write? Q is also a reactant.
So I should write negative sign.
Minus
1 by 2.
Then
delta concentration of Q by delta T.
R is a product. So there is no need of a negative sign.
Plus.
Then there is no coefficient here. So we can directly write
delta concentration of R by delta T
equal to, I have no space here, so I am writing here. You can write it anyway, you can write it continuously also. This one equal to this one equal to this one equal to this one, like that you can write. Now, S is a product, so positive sign. Since it was 3, you wrote 1 by 3. Since it was 2, you wrote 1 by 2. Here it is 1 by 2. So what it will be? 1 by 1 by 2. If it was 3, 1 by 3. If it was 2, 1 by 2. Here it is 1 by 2. So we need to write the fraction 1 by 1 by 2. That is 2. 2 into
delta concentration of S by delta T.
Okay? Then, dear students, we can find average rate from this one, from this one, from this one, or from this one. Anyway, and now, without fraction, this is rate of disappearance of P. If you are not considering this fraction and you are finding only this thing, that will be rate of disappearance of P. And here also, without considering fraction, this one is rate of disappearance of Q. Here there is no fraction, so average rate is nothing but rate of formation of R. Both will be same. Here, this one is rate of formation of S. Without that number, this one will be rate of formation of S. In the case of reactants, we will say rate of disappearance. In the case of product, we will say rate of formation, because reactants are disappearing and products are forming. If you consider that fraction also, then that is average rate. If you are not considering that fraction, then that will become rate of disappearance of P, rate of disappearance of Q, rate of formation of R. Here rate of formation of R is equal to average rate. Here rate of formation of S is not equal to average rate. If you multiply rate of formation of S with a number 2, then you will get average rate. I hope it's clear for you, and then we will do another problem. With that problem, we will wind up today's session, and that is our last question. You need to understand that. This type of questions are typical in board exam. It has been asked so many times. Okay. So please take care of it. How will you write instantaneous rate? I need not to say that. Just to replace delta with D. How will you write instantaneous rate? It's very easy. Just to replace delta with D. Okay. Fine. Next question. It's a numerical question. Please write down. Consider the reaction
A plus 2B giving 2C plus 3D.
Consider the reaction A plus 2B giving 2C plus 3D.
Concentration of B
changes from
10 mole per liter to 2 mole per liter in 2 seconds.
This is the only data that is supplied. Concentration of B changes from 10 mole per liter to 2 mole per liter in 2 seconds. What a fast reaction. Within 2 seconds, concentration of B changes from 10 mol per liter to 2 mol per liter. Okay. Here is the question. Find the average rate of the reaction. Find rate of disappearance of A and B. Also find rate of formation of C and D. Such a large question, but it is very easy. I will solve it for you. Concentration of B is changing from 10 mol per liter to 2 mol per liter. It is decreasing because B is a reactant in 2 seconds. Now listen. We will write the expression for average rate. We will write the expression for average rate. Average rate equal to, first we need to consider A. Minus, there is no fraction because A is having coefficient 1. Minus delta concentration of A by delta T equal to, again it is reactant, we need to add minus 1 by 2 delta concentration of B by delta T equal to, here it is product, so positive value, plus 1 by 2 delta concentration of C by delta T equal to, again plus value, it will be plus 1 by 3 delta concentration of D by delta T. Is it clear? First we will write the expression. Now it is very easy for you. In reactants we need negative, product we need positive. What is the purpose of that? The reaction rate should be positive. That's why we are making these changes. Rate should be positive. That's why this is taken negative and negative. So that rate will become positive. We will understand it. And the data given is about B. So we will write only about B. The data given is about B. So we will write only about B. Average rate equal to minus 1 by, we will write only this much. We will write only this thing. Because data given is about B. Minus 1 by 2 delta concentration of B by delta T. Minus 1 by 2 delta concentration of B by delta T. And see, minus 1 by 2. Change in concentration of B. It is changing from 10 mol to 2 mol. So final minus initial. Always it should be final minus initial. So final it is 2. Initially it was 10. So 2 minus 10 by 2 time 2. So it will become 2 minus 10 minus 8. Minus of minus 8 plus 8. Now did you understand why we are writing negative in reactants? Because this change will be negative in the case of reactant. So to avoid that we are putting a negative. Now see, our answer will become positive. Okay. 2 minus 10 is minus 8. Minus of minus 8 plus 8. In the denominator we have 2 into 2, 4. 8 by 4. Answer is 2 mol liter raised to minus 1 second raised to minus 1. Answer is 8 by 4, that is 2 mol liter raised to minus 1 second raised to minus 1. Is it clear, students? Okay. I expect your feedbacks. Please feel free to send WhatsApp message about your feedback about the class. Okay. Any doubts, suggestions, complaints, whatever. Now, 8 by 4 equal to 2 mol liter raised to minus 1 second raised to minus 1. So we got average rate. Next, see what I am going to do. One part of the question has already been answered. Average rate we got 2 mol liter raised to minus 1 second raised to minus 1. Now what to do next? You will substitute 2 here. You will substitute 2 here. Write it again. Okay. Write it again. Now I am not writing it again because it will take time. You write it again by replacing average rate with 2 mol liter raised to minus 1 second raised to minus 1. Don't forget about the unit of the rate. Mol liter raised to minus 1 second raised to minus 1. 2. Okay, 2 mol liter raised to minus 1, second raised to minus 1. Now rate of disappearance of A. Rate of disappearance of A means this one. That will be equal to average rate.
So, rate of disappearance of A. Rate of disappearance of A equal to same thing, average rate itself, because there is no other coefficient. 2 mol liter raised to minus 1, second raised to minus 1.
Now rate of disappearance of B, we need to find out the rate of disappearance of B.
Rate of disappearance of B.
Remember, we need not to consider that fraction. We need to find this one without fraction. We need to consider this thing without fraction. So this 2, we need to bring it here. This 2 is in denominator. When you move it to the left side, that will become upside. That is 2 into 2. Already there is 2. When this 2 goes there, it will become 2 into 2 equal to 4 mol liter raised to minus 1, second raised to minus 1. I hope you understood the technique. Now let's find out rate of formation of C.
Rate of formation of C.
How will you find out the rate of formation of C?
We need only this part.
So to get that part, you take this 2 to this side. So again, this one also will become
2 into 2 equal to 4 mol liter raised to minus 1, second raised to minus 1.
Now the last one, rate of formation of D.
Rate of formation of D.
Rate of formation of D. What will be rate of formation of D? Rate of formation of D. What it will be? Rate of formation of D equal to, here we need to get only this part. We need not to consider this fraction. So this fraction we will take it to the left side.
3, if you take it here, it will be 3 into 2. So the answer is 3 into 2 equal to 6 mol liter raised to minus 1, second raised to minus 1.
Okay. Now I will give you one more question, but not here. You send me a WhatsApp message about the homework question. I will give you the homework question. After solving, you send it back. Okay? Because I just want to know how many students are really watching all these videos. Okay? How many students are really understanding all these things. Okay, thank you students. Next day, tomorrow we will continue with the next section of chemical kinetics. It's going to be very easy. What all things we have studied today? Today we have studied about what is chemical kinetics, what is its importance, how it is connected to thermodynamics, how it is connected to equilibrium. Then second thing, what is the purpose of studying chemical kinetics? Third thing, how to write average rate, how to write instantaneous rate, how to find rate of formation, how to find rate of disappearance. We have studied about how to solve a particular type of problems. Okay, that's all for today. So next day, we will explore more about the most interesting branch, chemical kinetics. Thank you, students. See you.